Hi students, welcome to Easy Chemistry by Pathan. And today we are going to discuss about hydrocarbons, especially classification of hydrocarbons, alkanes, alkenes, alkynes in detail. What is meant by hydrocarbons? Hydrocarbons nothing but compounds which are having carbon and hydrogen atoms only. Compounds which are having carbon and hydrogen only is called hydrocarbons. Hydrogen and carbon atoms only, no other atom. Only hydrogen and carbon. And what are the main sources of this hydrocarbons? Means hydrocarbons main source of hydrocarbon is petroleum. You know petroleum is a crude oil, coal, natural gas and so on. These are the main sources of hydrocarbons: petroleum, coal, natural gas. You know very well we are using in daily life LPG, CNG. These all are petroleum products only. Like LPG, we have liquefied petroleum gas. And CNG, compressed natural gas, and we have LNG, liquefied natural gas, and these all are petroleum products only. LPG, CNG, LNG, liquefied petroleum gas, compressed natural gas, liquefied natural gas, these are petroleum products. And these we have as the sources. Classification. Hydrocarbons are classified into three types. One is saturated hydrocarbons. The second one, unsaturated. The third one, aromatic. Saturated hydrocarbons, unsaturated hydrocarbons, and aromatic hydrocarbons. Let me discuss about this. First one we have saturated hydrocarbons. What is meant by saturated hydrocarbons? Here all carbon valence is satisfied, and moreover carbon bonded with single bond. All the carbon atoms as well as carbon and hydrogen atoms bonded with a single bond. Between carbon and carbon, carbon and hydrogen, all are having single bond. If all are bonded with a single bond, that is we are calling saturated hydrocarbons. These saturated hydrocarbons we are calling as alkanes. Saturated hydrocarbons called as alkanes. You know very well alkanes having C single bond C only. All atoms bonded with single bond, and these are depicted with general formula Cn H2N plus 2, where N equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. Saturated hydrocarbons called as alkanes. All the atoms are bonded with a single bond, depicted with a general formula CnH2n plus 2, where n 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You know, examples, if carbon is 1, that is n number is 1, CH4. If n equal to 2, C2H6. If n equal to 3, C3H8. These are the alkanes. One carbon is there, meth. Single bond is there, ene, methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, like that. So, the suffix we have here, that is ene. So, single bond is there, single bond we are calling as ene. One carbon is meth, two carbon eth, three carbon prop, like that. Single bond is there, ene. So, these alkanes are called with another name, paraffins. Paraffins. Paraffins means little reactive. Means alkanes are very less reactive. This paraffin word came from param and affins. Param means little, affins means reactivity, affinity. Little reactive or little affinity. Because all carbon valences are satisfied, they are already saturation. That's why chemical reactivity is less. Not zero. Not zero. Chemical reactivity very less. Clear? CnH2n plus 2. This is the general formula. CnH2n plus 2. This you have to remember. No need to buy out all. If n you will substitute here, methane, ethane, propane, butane, pentane, like that you are getting the compounds. And another name is paraffins. Paraffins means little affinity or little reactive. And these alkanes, again, different types. Alkanes are, we have different types again. Like N alkanes, iso alkanes, neo alkanes, and the fourth one we have cycloalkanes. Alkanes are different type again. N alkanes, minimum 3 carbons we need. Isoalkane, minimum 4 carbons. Neo, 5 carbons. And cyclo, N start from 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. With 2 carbon, no cyclo. So like this alkanes we have 4 types. N alkanes, isoalkanes, neoalkanes, cycloalkanes. N alkane, isoalkane, neoalkane, cycloalkane. Like I am discussing this, when we have to say N, iso, neo and cyclo. First one I am taking here, N alkane. N means normal alkane. N alkane nothing but normal alkane. For example, I am taking here butane formula C4H10. butane formula C4H10. Now this is I am writing as open chain, CH3 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 bond, CH3. This is the open chain. Open chain. See here, now this carbon bonded with other carbon, one carbon. So this carbon we are calling 1 degree. This carbon bonded other 2. This is 2 degree. This carbon 2 degree. This carbon 1 degree. This carbon directly bonded with 1 degree. This carbon directly bonded with 2 degree. This carbon also directly bonded with 2 degree. This carbon directly bonded with 1 degree. If a carbon chain, that is alkane, having only 1 degree and 2 degree carbon, that is we are calling an alkane. This is we are calling N-butane. So 1 degree and 2 degree carbon atoms only present, such alkanes we are calling N-alkanes. N-alkane is the alkane which contains only 1 degree 2 degree carbon atoms. This is we are calling N-butane. What we are calling? N-butane. Am I right? This is N-butane. 5 carbons are there, N-pentane. 3 are there, N-propane, like that. Now it is clear. N-alkane, nothing but normal alkane. For example, I took butane, 4 carbon. I wrote as the open chain. This open chain contains only 2 types of carbons, 1 degree, 2 degree. 1 degree means a carbon directly bonded with 1 carbon. This is not directly. 1 degree, a carbon with 2 other directly, 2 degree, like that. So only 1 degree and 2 degree carbons attached, such we are calling normal alkanes, whatever it may be. Normal propane, normal butane, normal pentane, like that. This is about N alkane. Minimum 3 carbons required. Next, go for here. I am taking isoalkanes. What is meant by isoalkanes? See here, I am taking butane formula C4H10. C4H10. With this already I explained N-alkane. See here, CH3. Previously I told this is N-butane because contains 1 degree, 2 degree carbon atoms only. And this chain can be written as like this also. This chain can be written as like this also. See, 1 CH3 bond, C bond, CH3, and here I am writing 1 CH3, and this is CH. See here, 4 carbon atoms are there, no change, and 10 hydrogens are there, 10 hydrogens. See here, first carbon, second carbon, third carbon. This is parental chain. And here one substitution. This substitution present at second last. This is last carbon, this is second last. If methyl group is present at second last carbon, that is we are calling isobutane. I repeat, if the second last carbon having methyl group, such group we are calling iso group. This is the group iso group. 4 carbons are there, butane, isobutane. So second last carbon, 1 methyl group. If the second last carbon contains 1 methyl group, such compound we are calling iso compounds. Clear? Next, Another we have third type, neoalkanes. Neoalkanes. Go for here, I am taking pentane C5H12. So neo means compulsory, minimum 5 carbon atoms are required. This I am writing now as first one CH3 bond, CH2 bond, CH2 bond, CH3. This is 1 degree, this is 2 degree, this is 2 degree, 1 degree. This is now N-pentane. What we are calling? N-pentane. Only 1 degree, 2 degree is there, na? That's why N-pentane. Go for now. Here, another compound I am writing. CH3, bond CH, bond CH3, bond CH2, bond CH3. Look here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Second, this is the now second last carbon. 1, 2, 3. From this side. From this side. 1, 2, 3. From this side. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. This is methyl group. This is iso group we have. So this is we are calling iso pentane. What we are calling? Isopentane. Isopentane. Now this compound we can write like this. One carbon, methyl group, methyl group, methyl group, methyl group. A carbon with four other carbons directly bonded. Directly bonded. See here, 1, 2, 3. This is last carbon, this is second last. If second last carbon having two methyl groups, that is we are calling neo. This is neopentane. Neopentane. Second last carbon having one methyl group, iso. And second last carbon having two methyl group, neo. That you have to remember. Second last carbon having one methyl group, iso. Second last carbon having two methyl groups, neo. That is how to give the iso, neo and N-pentane. Next, we have one more. That is cycloalkanes. Cyclo nothing but cyclic. Means closed chains. Closed chains. All carbon atoms formed as a ring. Formed as a ring. That we are calling cycloalkanes. Here, minimum 3 carbon atoms are required. 3 carbon atoms are required. How many you need? Minimum 3 carbon atoms are required. If 3 carbon atoms not there, cyclocompounds will not form. That you have to remember. See here, I am taking cyclopropane. Cyclopropane. So this we have here like this. This is cyclic. Means 3 carbon atoms. Here this is CH2 bond. CH2 bond, this is CH2, cyclopropane, am I right? Means cyclocompounds having different formula, that is CnH2n, CnH2n, alkanes having CnH2n plus 2, cycloalkanes having CnH2n. You take 3 here, C3, here 2 into 3, 6, C3H6, C3H6, this is C3H6 only, cyclo, word we have to add, this is propane, cyclic ring is there, cyclopropane, cyclic alkanes general formula CnH2n. This you have to remember. CnH2n. That is cyclic alkanes. That is cycloalkanes. Cycloalkanes are alkanes which are having cyclic chains, that is closed chains. We are calling ring. Minimum 3 carbon atoms are required. Example, cyclopropane. This is CH2. You can write like this also, or you can draw like this also. Both are same only. And general formula CnH2n is the general formula. Alkanes CnH2n plus 2. Cycloalkanes CnH2n only. Where n is equal to 3, 4, 5 and so on. But in alkanes n starts from 1, 2, 3, 4. In cycloalkane 3, 4, 5. That is types of alkanes. Types of alkanes. N-alkane, isoalkane, neoalkane and cycloalkanes. Cycloalkanes having different formula. Clear? Now, in alkanes, four types of carbons are present. Already I explained to you. One more time I am going to explain. In alkanes, four types of carbon atoms present. In alkanes, four types of carbon atoms are present. Example, I am going to explain in detail. What are those means? See here, one chain I am taking here. This is the carbon chain. Carbon chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here one methyl group is there. And this is 1 and this is 1. I am not writing all hydrogens. Try to understand. Clear? And this is the chain is given to you. Here I am writing. This is the chain is given to you. Types of carbons we have to address. Types of carbons. See here. This carbon directly bonded with one carbon. This is we are calling 1 degree. This carbon directly bonded with one carbon. This is also 1 degree. This carbon directly bonded with one. This is also 1 degree. This carbon directly bonded with one. This is also 1 degree. This carbon directly bonded with two other carbons. This is we are calling 2 degree. 2 degree. Clear? And you go for this carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4. This carbon is 4 degree. This carbon is 4 degree. See this carbon. 1, 2, 3. This is 3 degree. So, 1 carbon with 1 carbon, 1 degree. 1 carbon with 2 carbons, 2 degree. 1 carbon with 3 carbons, 3 degree. 1 carbon with 4 carbon, 4 degree. 1 degree carbon we are calling primary carbon. 2 degree carbon we are calling secondary carbon. 3 degree carbon we are calling tertiary carbon. And 4 degree carbon we are calling quaternary carbon. Or neocarbon. So one degree nothing but one carbon directly with another carbon. Primary. 2 degree means one carbon directly with other two carbon. Secondary. 3 degree means one carbon directly with other 3. 1, 2, 3. This carbon. Tertiary. And 4 degree. One carbon with other 4 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is 4 degree. 4 degree means quaternary or neo. So in alkanes, we can observe primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary or neo. 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, 4 degree carbons. This is very important. You have to remember. Clear? That is about alkanes. Now, a little bit more information I am going to give about alkanes. That is, already I told that alkanes are saturated compounds. Means carbon, carbon, single bond only. All four valences of carbon, single bond. That's why hybridization is sp3. Remember, hybridization is sp3. In alkanes, because all carbons with other carbons or hydrogens bonded with a single bond, that's why sp3 hybridization. And bond length between carbon and carbon is 154 picometers. And the bond energy between carbon and carbon is nearly 413 kilojoule per mole. So this is useful for competitive. You have to remember, in alkanes, all the atoms, whether carbon-carbon or carbon-hydrogen, bonded with single bond. That's why sp3 hybridization. Bond length between carbon and carbon single bond, 154 picometers or 1.54 angstrom unit. 1.54 angstrom unit. Bond energy means to break the bond, 413 kilojoule per mole. And this you have to remember, very important for competitive concern. Clear? That is about in detail alkanes. See here. Hydrocarbons, compounds with having only carbon and hydrogen, is called hydrocarbons. Sources: petroleum, coal, natural gas, and so on. This LPG, CNG, LNG, these we are using the petroleum products. And these hydrocarbons are three types: saturated, unsaturated, aromatic. Saturated means all carbon valences are satisfied. And if carbon is bonded with a single bond, all, and carbon with hydrogen, all bonded with single bond, is called saturated. And saturated hydrocarbons are called as alkanes. So alkane, nothing but all carbon atoms are bonded with a single bond only. General formula: CN H2N plus 2, where N stands for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. If N is equal to 1, methane, 2, ethane, 3, propane, 4, butane, like that. So it ends with N. Alkanes ends with N. Clear? And this another name, paraffins, derived from two words, param and affins. Param means little. Affins means reactivity or affinity. Little reactive. Because of all saturated bonds, chemical reactivity of alkanes is very less. These we have different types. N-alkanes with 3 carbon. Isoalkane with 4 carbon minimum. Neoalkanes with 5 carbons minimum. Cycloalkanes starts from 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. With 2 carbons, there is no cycloalkanes. Normal alkanes. N alkanes, nothing but normal alkane. So to show the normal alkanes, generally we need minimum 3, more than 3 also. Butane I took, C4H10. So I splitted this molecule into open chain. This is compressed one and this is open chain. CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. See here, in this chain, 1 degree, 2 degree carbons only is there. If the open chain of alkane having only 1 degree, 2 degree carbon atoms, and such molecules we are calling N alkanes. This is N butane. N butane means normal butane. N butane means normal butane. And likewise, we have here isoalkanes. I took butane as the compound C4H10. Already I told N butane, now isobutane. And here I wrote CH3CH CH3, one substituent. Second last carbon having methyl group, we have to say iso. And four carbons are there, butane. Next, neoalkane. Minimum neo means five carbon atoms we need compulsory. Neobutane not there, neopropane not there. So pentane we have to take. C5H12, and this N pentane, isopentane, and here neopentane. Neopentane, the neo word when we have to use means second last carbon having two methyl groups. Second last carbon having two methyl groups. So second last carbon, one methyl group iso, two methyl group neo. Cyclocompounds. Cyclocompounds nothing but all carbon atoms are merged into cyclic ring. Minimum three carbons are required. Cyclopropane, and this is and cyclic compound general formula, that is cycloalkane general formula CnH2n. N value starts from 3, 4, 5. That is about cycloalkanes. Next, we have in alkanes four types of carbon atoms: primary, secondary, tertiary, quaternary. Quaternary nothing but neo. In alkanes, all carbon atoms bonded with a single bond, that's why hybridization sp3. Bond length between carbon and carbon 154 picometer. Bond disassociation energy means to break the bond, we need 413 kilojoule per mole. This is detailed information about alkanes. And in alkanes, one more information I am giving. We have primary alkane, that is methane. This methane we are calling as marsh gas. Remember, common name or general name is methane is marsh gas. It available at marshy places, that's why methane we are calling as marsh gas. Important for competitive, which gas, which alkane is known as marsh gas means methane. Methane is well known as a marsh gas. Marsh gas. Next, another type of hydrocarbon, that is alkenes. Alkenes. You know what is the meaning for alkenes? Alkenes nothing but hydrocarbons which are having at least one double bond between carbon and carbon. Because of having double bond, this is we are calling unsaturated hydrocarbons. Clear? If unsaturated hydrocarbon may contains carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond. If double bond is present, that is alkenes we are calling. Triple bond is present, alkynes. Clear? So at least one double bond is there, alkene. Alkene general formula CnH2n, where N stands for 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on, not 1, 2, 3. Go for here example, I am taking N equal to 2. You are getting C2H4 ethene. What we are calling? Ethene. If N equal to 3 and you are getting C3H6. This is 3 carbon prop. Double bond is there, ene, propene. So generally alkenes ends with ene. Alkenes, ene. Alkenes, ene. three carbons, like that butene, pentene, hexane, heptane, like that. Clear? Alkenes minimum, we need one double bond between two carbons, between two carbons. And alkenes well known as, olefins. Olefins means oil forming. So common name for alkenes, olefins. These are more reactive than alkenes. Alkenes are already saturated. Alkenes are unsaturated. Is reactivity of alkenes a little bit more than alkanes? Clear? For example, I am taking here pentene. How many carbon? Pent means 5. Ene means double bond. Pentene nothing but pent 1 ene. Pent 1 ene means 5 carbons. 5 carbons like this. Where we have first carbon with a double bond. CH2. This is CH3. CH2. CH. Double bond is there. At least one double bond required. All carbons no need. This is pent 1 ene or pentene. Pent 1 ene or pentene. Clear? Now, here one double bond is there now in all alkenes. This double bond stands for 1 sigma, 1 pi. That you have to remember. In a double bond, 1 sigma bond, 1 pi bond. That you have to remember. In any double bond, 1 sigma bond and 1 pi bond is present. Single bond is there, sigma bond. Double bond is there, 1 sigma, 1 pi. Like that you have to consider. Sigma bond is strong than pi bond. Pi bond is weaker bond than sigma bond. More reactive than alkenes. Now, this is double bond system we have. This is like this double bonded system. That's why undergo sp2 hybridization. All single bonds are there, sp3. Double bond is there, sp2. And the bond energy, bond length between two double bonded carbons is 134 picometers. And the bond energy means bond dissociation energy between carbon and carbon double bonded, we have 681 picometers. Kilojoule per mole. Clear? See here in alkenes, sp3. In alkenes, sp2. In alkenes, bond length 154 picometer. Alkenes 134. Bond energy 413. Here 681 kilojoule per mole. Means as number of bonds increasing, bond length decreasing, bond disassociation energy increasing. Here single bond we have to break, that's why less energy. Here two bonds we have to break, that's why more energy. Here single bond, bond length 154. Here double bond, bond length 134. Means as number of bonds increasing between two carbons or between two atoms, bond length decreasing, bond strength increasing. That you have to remember. That is about alkenes. Here also cyclic compounds are there. Cycloalkenes. Here also cycloalkenes are present. For example, see here, this is butane. One double bond is there. This is cyclobutene. What we are calling cyclobutene. Cycloalkanes are present. Like that, cycloalkenes also present. Four carbons, butane. Double bond is there. Sorry, four carbons, butane. Double bond is there. In butene, this is cyclic compound, cyclobutene, cyclopentene, like this. You, for example, this six carbons, hexane, double bond, hexene, and the cyclic compound, cyclohexene, what we are calling cyclohexene. So likewise in alkene, alkenes also having cyclic compound. Alkanes are sp3 hybridized, alkenes are sp2. Bond length less, bond strength is more. Bond strength is more. And the general formula for alkenes, CnH2n. General formula you have to remember, CnH2n. No need to by heart all alkenes. All alkenes. Clear na? Unsaturated compounds. Unsaturated compounds. Go for another unsaturated compounds we have, that is alkynes. Another unsaturated hydrocarbon, alkynes. Alkynes. What is meant by alkynes? This is unsaturated. This is unsaturated. Carbon-carbon having at least one triple bond. One triple bond. In chain, at least one triple bond is there. That is alkyne. General formula, CnH2n minus 2, where n equal to 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. So there is no 1. With the 2 it will start. For example, n equal to 2, then you are getting the compound C2H2. 2 carbons are there, ether. 3 carbons are there. Triple bond is there, iron. Triple bond is there, iron. So this is we are calling ethane, or common name acetylene. What we are calling acetylene. And you go for n equal to 3. C3H4. Propyne. Propyne. N equal to 4. Then you are getting C4H6. This is we are calling butyne. Butyne. So general formula you have to remember. General formula, you have to remember, ethyne, propyne, butyne, pentyne, like that. This ethyne, general name or common name, acetylene. Remember this acetylene. This we are using in oxyacetylene flame. Oxyacetylene flame. Clear? In alkanes, in alkynes, carbon-carbon bonded with a triple bond. Triple bond. That's why hybridization is sp. Sp hybridization. Clear? And triple bond means, triple bond means 1 sigma, 2 pi bonds. 1 sigma and 2 pi bonds. So in triple bond, 1 sigma plus 2 pi bonds, total 3 bonds. Double bond is there, 1 sigma, 1 pi. Single bond is there, sigma. Triple bond is there, 1 sigma bond and other 2 pi bonds. Total 3 bonds are present. Hybridization, sp. Sp hybridization. Alkynes undergo sp hybridization. And now, bond length. So, bond length between 2 carbons which are bonded with a triple bond triple bond 120 picometers. I told you, as number of bonds increasing, bond length decreasing, and the bond dissociation energy between carbon-carbon triple bond will increase. 823 kilojoule per mole. 823. As number of bonds increasing, bond length decreasing. Bond length decreasing. Bond energy increasing. So, here I am making number of bonds increasing, bond length decreasing, and number of bonds increasing, bond dissociation energy also increasing. This you have to remember. As number of bonds increasing, bond length decreasing. As number of bonds increasing, bond dissociation energy also increasing. Is it clear? That is about alkane, alkene, alkynes. These alkynes also, little bit unsaturation triple bond is there, and we need more energy to break, to participate in the reactions. That's why reactivity, little bit more only. And now, all these alkanes, alkenes, and alkynes exhibit isomerism. That you have to remember. All these three exhibiting isomerism. But different alkanes and alkenes and alkynes are showing different isomerism. But generally alkanes, alkenes, alkynes are all exhibiting isomerism. You know isomerism having same general formula but different structures. Clear? That is about alkynes. Alkynes are unsaturated, having at least one triple bond between two carbons with the general formula Cn, H2n minus 2, ends with ion. Minimum two carbons are required, with one carbon not there. Ethyne, acetylene, propyne, butyne, pentyne, like that. Due to having triple bond, undergo sp hybridization. Triple bond means 1 sigma, 2 pi bonds, total 3 bonds. As number of bonds between 2 carbon atoms increasing, bond length decreasing to 120 picometer, and bond energy increasing to 823 kilojoule per mole. It is very difficult to break 3 bonds at a time. Single bond we can break easily. But 3 bonds breaking means we need more energy. More energy. And alkanes we are calling paraffins. Alkenes, olefins. Alkynes we doesn't have any other name. Alkynes, alkynes only, but unsaturated with a triple bond. Alkenes unsaturated, double bond. Alkynes triple bond, unsaturated only. And all these alkanes, alkenes, alkynes exhibiting isomerism. That we'll discuss with a separate concept, isomerism. Next, the last type we have, aromatic hydrocarbons. Aromatic hydrocarbons. So this many times we discuss open chains, that is saturated and unsaturated. All are open chain and some are cyclic. Now aromatic. What is meant by aromatic hydrocarbons? Aromatic hydrocarbons. These are cyclic compounds. Cyclic compounds. Cyclic compounds with cyclic compounds with conjugation. Cyclic compound with conjugation. Cyclic compounds you know very well. What is meant by conjugation means, conjugation nothing but double single, double. This is the system we are calling conjugated system. Double single, double single system. Double single, double single. Clear? Like benzene ring. One double bond, one single bond. One double bond, one single bond. Like that. That is conjugation. And these are two types. Aromatic compounds are two types. So what is aromatic? Cyclic compounds with conjugation. Conjugation nothing but double single, double single. These are, we have two types. Benzenoids, for example, this is the benzene ring, you know very well. If the cyclic compound with the conjugation is benzene, that is benzenoid. This is we are calling benzene. Benzene. And similarly, two cyclic rings with conjugation, is there. This is also benzenoid. This is we are calling naphthalene. What we are calling? Naphthalene. If the cyclic compound with conjugation is benzene, benzenoid. If the cyclic compound with conjugation, benzene not there, that is we are calling non-benzenoids. Non-benzenoids. Cyclic compound, conjugation is there, but it is not benzene. It is not benzene. Go for here, I am giving. Cyclopropane. Cyclopropane. And here one hydrogen I am removing now. Plus charge. Double, single. Conjugation is there. Like this compound. This is not benzene. And here I am taking now cyclopentane. Two double bonds I am taking. Diene. And here I am adding one hydrogen. Negative charge. Double single. Double single. Conjugation is there. But it is not benzene. So this is non-benzenoid. Non-benzenoid. So aromatic compounds means cyclic compounds with the conjugation. Conjugation nothing but double single system. And this latter we'll discuss. And today concept I am explaining hydrocarbons, alkane, alkene and alkynes. And these aromatic compounds also exhibiting isomerism. So aromatic compound two types, benzenoid, non-benzenoid. If aromatic hydrocarbon with conjugation, if benzene is there, benzenoid. And benzene not there, non-benzenoids. Non-benzenoids. So you know very well benzene formula C6H6. Benzene formula C6H6. If two benzene ring attached, that is we are calling naphthalene. Naphthalene is a benzenoid. Why? Because benzene rings attached. Benzene ring attached. Am I right? So this is about a little bit introduction about hydrocarbons. So hydrocarbons are the compounds. Hydrocarbons are compounds having only hydrogen and carbon atoms. No other. It should contain hydrogen and carbon only. Only. Then only we have to say hydrocarbons. If other atoms included, that we should not call as hydrocarbons. Their derivatives we are calling. Where we are getting this all means, I told already. These are three types. Saturated, single bond. Unsaturated, double bond and triple bond. Aromatic, cyclic with conjugation. Aromatic means cyclic with conjugation. Saturated. If the carbon chain having all single bonds, such hydrocarbons we are calling saturated hydrocarbons. Whether carbon-carbon or carbon-hydrogen, must be single bond. Then how can we address, general formula is there. Cn H2n plus 2. N's begins with 1, 2, 3, 4. One carbon is there, CH4. Generally methane we are calling. 2 is there, ethane. 3 is there, propane. 4 is there, butane. That is, you can learn in IUPAC nomenclature. And these saturated hydrocarbons, alkanes, ends with AN. Single bond is there, AN. Another name is paraffins. This is derived from two words, param and affins. Param means little, affins means affinity, reactivity, little reactivity. Because of saturation, chemical reactivity of alkanes is less. And these alkanes, we have different types. N-alkanes means normal alkanes, isoalkanes, neoalkanes, cycloalkanes. N-alkanes minimum we need 3 carbon, iso 4 carbon, neo 5 carbon, cycloalkanes starts from 3, 4, 5 like N-alkanes. N-alkanes, these two are same, but it is open chain, this is cyclic chain, that is the difference, these two. Normal alkanes. Butane I took, C4H10, and this is one compressed one, and I am writing as the open chain, dash system, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. See this chain, having only 1 degree and 2 degree carbons. This is 1 degree, this is 2 degree, this is 2 degree, this is 1 degree. So if the open chain of alkane having only 1 degree, 2 degree carbon atoms, such alkanes we are calling N-alkanes. This is butane, this is N-butane, means normal butane. Next, iso. Isoalkanes. How can we say iso means? Very simple. If the second last carbon in the chain, second last carbon having methyl group, then we have to say iso. See here, from left to right you go. This is the second last carbon, left to right. This second last carbon having methyl group. Then this total group we are calling, iso group. Remember, iso group means CH3. Here vacancy is there. Somewhere you observe CH3 group like this. That group we are calling iso. Second last carbon having methyl group. Then isobutane. If this group not there, like this group, we should not call iso. Neo. Already I told neo need minimum 5 carbons. So I took here pentane. Here I shown N-pentane, 1 degree, 2 degree. Isopentane. See here second last carbon, this is, this we have here, CH3 group. See this group, CH3. This you take left to right, second last carbon. CH3 group is there, iso. Iso pentane. What we are calling? Iso pentane, N-pentane, isopentane. Means second last carbon having one methyl group. Go for here, this second last carbon having two methyl group. If second last carbon having two methyl group, then we have to say neo. Second last carbon one methyl group, iso. Second last carbon two methyl group, neo. So N-pentane, isopentane, neopentane. These all are isomers. Cycloalkane. This is normal alkanes only, but cyclic compound. General formula CnH2n. CnH2n. Minimum 3 carbons required. Before the name, we have to give cyclo word. Three carbons are there, prop, single bond ene, propane, and this is cyclic ring. All carbons are merged, that's why cyclopropane. Four carbons are there, cyclobutane. For example, here this you take. Four carbons are there, cyclobutane, and here you go for six carbons are there, six carbons, cyclohexane, and you go for here five carbons are there, cyclopentane, cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, cyclohexane. Means all carbons formed as a ring. Such compounds we are calling cycloalkanes. Before the name we have to add cyclo. Propane is there, cyclopropane. Butane is there, cyclobutane. Pentane is there, cyclopentane. And alkanes are saturated sp3 hybridization. Likewise remaining alkenes and alkynes also. Still, if you have faced any difficulty in this basics of hydrocarbons, you make a comment and I will give the answer. Thank you.